Have you ever wanted to create a snowy shot, but you were worried about the snow material? If so, you are in the good place, as today I will show you how to create a snowy asphalt material. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will show you a nice way to create a snowy asphalt with tire tracks. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, so let's start with the texture selection. First of all, I'll be using materials from the Polygon website to create the snow, so I put the link to these particular textures in the description below. It's in the snow and ice section, and I choose this one, plus this one as a base. So here we'll have the tire tracks. Here is how it looks, and we can see what the real scale is. And here is our base snow now. We also can see the size of the texture in real life. It will be good for our snowy asphalt material. Okay, so as we know what textures we need, let's open the 3ds Max. So I have a simple scene prepared with a plane, camera, sky and sun added. So here is how it looks. To be able to work easily with polygon textures, you need to download your script from the website. Now it's a good idea to keep it on the toolbar panel, but always have it close. To do this, go to Customize, Customize User Interface, choose Toolbars, and look for Polygon category. Drag and drop this to the toolbar. Click on the icon and we'll open the Polygon Material Converter. We'll start with the tire track material. Choose the root folder where you have your downloaded textures. We can add the folder and select here what size we want. 6K will be good enough. And here, you can choose the render engine. I choose Corona, but if you're using V-Ray, choose V-Ray Renderer. We can select this option so the UVs will be adjusted from each map type to match the texture dimensions. Load material. Great. Open the material editor and scroll down to the temporary library and drag and drop the material. Awesome. We have the whole structure of the snow tire track material done. Let's apply it to the plane. Let's go inside the color map. You can see that we have the tiling set up here. Let's add UVW map modifier. And here is why it's cool to have these dimensions, so we can easily set the mapping correctly. So we need to type 300 cm to 300 cm and all will be good. Let's turn on the visibility of the map. Here we go. Let me show you how it looks on the render. Nice depth, isn't it? Let's go back to the Polygon script and let's import another material as well. The procedure is exactly the same. Choose the folder. Leave only the size of the textures you want. Don't forget to check the Confirm UV Map to Image Dimensions. Load material. Drag and drop new material to the material editor. Nice! Now let's turn off the alpha map from opacity and let's create a corona layered material. I show you what material to use in V-Ray. I need to change the render engine for a moment. So in V-Ray, you'll need to choose V-Ray Blend Material. So everything is pretty similar, just naming is different. So we have code materials and blend amounts instead of layers and masks. The base material is the same. Okay, so I go back to the Corona renderer. Okay, so I use the first material as a base material, alpha map from it will be our mask. And at the end, let's connect the second material to the layer 1 slot. And let's apply this newly created material to the surface. And let's start rendering. Now, you can notice that the material works opposite than we wanted. We can simply change it by inverting output in the alpha map. Here we go. Now it looks good. By the way, this tutorial is part of one of the lessons from our Advanced Exterior Visualization course. So if you would like to make your snowy image super realistic and create images like this, there is much more to do than in this tutorial. For example, snow prints, creating more tire tracks that imitate car turnings, adding more material layers, and so on. The lesson we've recorded for the course only for the snow material took us 3 hours in total. Of course, after edit it will be shorter, but still you can get an idea on how much more you can do with your snow image. Okay, let's go back to 3ds Max. Let's turn off the displacement map from both materials for a moment to work on some details. But first, let's change the map channel in all maps from the second material to 2. And let's add another UVW map modifier. We can simply copy the previous one. Remember to change the map channel here as well. And this time, we need to set the length and width to 150 cm to make it look realistic. Now look here. We have this white strip from the first map, but it looks unnatural, so we need to fix it. We want to have the second material here, so let's move the composite that we have plugged to the diffuse slot close to the composite from the first material. We'll blend them together. Let's choose the composite map from the general panel. This map will be our layer 1. Now let's add one more layer and add another map to the layer 2 slot. And now let's choose the correct blend mode. I always scroll through them to find the best fit. Okay, I think the spotlight works the best. Actually, I think hard light will be better. Let's plug it into the diffuse slot. Let's check how it looks on the render. Okay, I don't think it works perfectly. Let's check options one more time. Okay, darken works great. We can move maps back to make everything clean and easily understandable. Now we can work on the displacement. Let me show you. Again, we'll use the composite map. The first map should be plugged into the layer 1 slot. Add a new layer and plug it into the layer 2 slot. And finally, let's use the alpha map as a mask for layer 2. Now let's add the displacement modifier. For the corona, we'll choose the corona displacement mode, and for V-Ray, choose the V-Ray displacement mode. Okay, copy the map to the custom slot. And let's increase the max level to 3 cm. And let's render. Okay, let's increase it even more, 15 cm. So you can see that now it's too much on the tire track part. What we can do is to change the opacity of the first map, but it doesn't give us too much control. The map is mixed with black, so we have these weird holes where the tire tracks are in the asphalt. Not good, right? But I have a solution for this, so don't worry, I'll show you right now. I will choose the mix map and plug the first displacement map into the color 1 slot. Then I plug it into the layer 1 slot. So now we'll be mixing the map with white. So we can notice that the tire track part has been flattered. So the lower the value, the lower the tire tracks are. So if we want to have them flat, we need to go to higher values. So I think we can go for somewhere around 75. Okay, nice. I like it. But now, I would like to have more snow. Can we change it? Sure we can. We can control it by color. So if we go to black, we have these weird holes. But when we go towards more gray colors, this distance is lowering. So in real life, when the car creates the tire tracks, they will make the fresh snow flatten. To achieve this effect, we can set something around 230. So we have a bit more snow on top. Plus, have these tire tracks created. Awesome. Now, this is a great base for the snowy shot. However, if you would like to know how to create the whole snowy scenario image like I've shown you before, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced exterior visualization course. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye!